Hello, 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 guys. How are you guys doing tonight? My name is Kim Douglas, coming to you from Prosperous Property Investments. Just coming to share some prosperity points with you to help you out a little bit in your life, help you out a little bit in your business. Yes, it's Sunday, and see how this goes, right? So today I am going to be talking about breaking your bad habit so that it doesn't break you. You know, break your bad habit or it'll break you, right? So that's what I am going to get into briefly after I share this. So as you're coming in, go ahead and let me know how you're feeling today. Let me know what's going on in your world. Let me know. Really quickly, let me know if I'm coming in loud and clear. And we'll get this thing started. So yes, we're talking about breaking the bad habits. Yes, because bad habits, you got to realize it's something. Sometimes you might not even realize that it's a habit and it's bad until somebody else brings it to your attention, you know. But if we're about, you know, prospering and moving forward, we got to start fixing these things that can get in the way and hold us back, right? So I shared that really briefly in a group, and we are going to get this thing started, right? So I watched this video today. The video was actually called, let me see here. It was a TED Talk video, and it was called A Simple Way to Break a Bad Habit. And it was by somebody named Judson Brewer. Really awesome topic. Pretty amazing, you know. I was just like, wow, you know, hopefully I do this justice. But just the concept that he was talking about was pretty cool. So that's what I want to tell you about today. So basically what he talked about was, you know, we all have bad habits, you know. We just have to, and how do we change them? How do we fix them, right? So he went into several examples of just, you know, a couple things he talked about. Two examples he used was chocolate and cigarette smoking. So I'll just go ahead with what he talked about in the video, right? So, you know, why is it hard for everyone to pay attention? You know, we all have so many distractions and things going on, right? And part of what happens with our minds is, you know, we're always focusing on positive and negative reinforcement. So every stimulation around you is either a positive or a negative reinforcement, right? So basically, what that breaks down into is that, you know, you have a trigger, then you have a behavior, then you have a reward. So basically, the trigger is, you know, the bad habit. You know, the trigger is something that, no, actually, the trigger is something that would cause you to have any habit, whether it's a bad habit or a good habit. And then based on doing that, you get a reward, like an internal reward. So one example he gave was chocolate. Okay, so chocolate is actually, you know, a food, and I am so guilty of this, guilty all the way, like working on it. But yeah, so he said that, like, when you eat something like chocolate or something that's sweet, your body, it automatically needs food, right? So you want to give your body what it needs. But when you eat something sweet, you take that from being a physical response to an emotional response. So basically what you do is, like I said, you have a trigger, you have a behavior, then you have a reward, right? So what happens is you see the food, you eat the food, and you repeat. And why do you repeat this? You know, because it feels good. It feels good to your body. So whatever you like and whatever you want more of, you go after it and you do that. Hey, how are you doing? I see you're up late like me. But yes, so you see the trigger, you do that behavior, and then you reward yourself. Like I said, with chocolate, this is me. Like he said, like, and this is greater when it is linked to stress. So like I said, that 'cause a big thing for me, like if I'm stressed out, it'll be like, oh my God, I need a piece of chocolate. Because with this same response, I know that's a bad habit, but only because it's like you're giving into the urge, you're seeing that, okay, this is gonna help me calm down, you know, and then you're gonna continue to repeat that, even though inside your mind, I know that I probably shouldn't have chocolate every time I get upset. You know, like it's just, you know, but we know in our mind that it's not good for us, but it's a habit. It's a bad habit that you have to break. He gave another really powerful example about smoking. And he said that usually what happens when someone starts smoking is, maybe they're a nerd in high school or something like that, or, and then they see some cool kids smoking a cigarette, and then they try it to mimic being cool, So then, based on that and that feeling that it gave you, you kept doing it. So for whatever reason you started your bad habit, you started it and you kept doing it, right? So how do we change these habits? Like I said, we all have them. You know what your bad habits are. If not, then talk to one of your close friends and they'll tell you, right? So how do you change these bad habits, right? So you have to change that pattern. So like I said, the original pattern is something triggers you to have, to cause a behavior, which is your bad habit. And then based on that, you get like an internal, emotional reward. But he said, you don't want to just tell yourself to quit. You can't just say, hey, I'm going to quit. Sometimes that works with people quitting stuff cold turkey. Usually it's a little bit more difficult than that. So this is what he said that you should do. And I'm going to kind of reference a study that he did with a group of people who were heavy smokers, right? So what he did with this group of people who were heavy smokers, he didn't say, hey, we want you to quit smoking, because it's almost like when you have a habit, you can't always just say, hey, I'm going to stop this. Something has to trigger you in reverse to stop doing that habit, right? So he said with a group of smokers, he told them to focus on just basically the cause, or how they feel. Basically, focus on curiosity is what he said. So he said, continue smoking, but focus on being curious about what you're doing. So he didn't say, hey, stop smoking. He said, just as you're smoking, just be curious about what you're doing, right? So why curiosity? So the curiosity actually, it mimics the feeling of feeling good, and also it brings awareness. Okay, so when you're being curious, you're wanting to get more knowledge and you're wanting to find an answer. Like your mind is wanting to find an answer, right, to whatever question you have. Have you ever had something like that? Like, oh my God, this is bothering me. I have to find out the answer. Same thing, right? So they said to just be curious about smoking, just think about it, So after the lady, he said they gave this really powerful example, of one lady in the group. She kept doing this process over and over. And then she started to realize, like in her curiosity, she started to realize that smoking tasted bad and it smelled yucky and it was disgusting. He didn't tell her to stop smoking. He didn't tell her to stop doing the bad habit. He started to tell her, he made her be aware of what that habit was doing. So basically, the same thing like with the chocolate, or with the smoking, or any other bad habit that you have, he said, focus on, what is that actually causing? Like cause and effect. Become aware of, if I eat chocolate every single time I get upset or stressed out, what is the effect that might have on my body? Or if I, overreact every time my husband bothers me, what is the cause going to be, or the effect going to be on our relationship? So you have to start thinking about that, not necessarily thinking about, oh my God, I need to stop this. Yes, you already know that in your mind, but you haven't stopped it already. He said, start thinking about the effects of what you're doing. And then naturally, you'll see that as a consequence that, okay, I know that this is really bad because this keeps happening every time I do this. So you got to be aware. That's step number one. Be aware. Be mindful of, like I said, the effects of what you're doing, and that will help you naturally change and stop those bad habits. Like I said, it's all about being aware. And he said you can change that original pattern, which is you have that trigger, something that, bothers you or alerts you in some kind of way. You have your behavior, which is your either bad habit or good habit. It could be a good or bad habit. And then your reward. But in this case, we're just going to leave it as a bad habit. And then your reward, which is, you reacting in a manner in such to way make yourself feel good, So he said to change that pattern to, you know, you have a trigger, which is like an urge, right? You're going to notice that urge, the same thing that triggered you before. But instead of reacting in that behavior, he said, get curious, you know, saying, hey, I did this last time, you know, and as a result, this was the effect, you know, this was the cause and the effect, you know, so get curious about where that can go, you know. Then he said, since you're aware, now you're knowing that, okay, this happens as a result of this. He said, feel the joy of letting go. So meaning you have self-control in that moment. You have the choice in that moment to react or to think this through, you know. So he said, in that awareness, you know, you're going to feel the joy of letting go and not giving in and then repeating. So instead of just repeating before the action of, you know, basically you lashing out or you, you know, you doing whatever that bad habit is, he said that just have curiosity to realize what that actually brings about, what that actually means, and then take control of it, saying, you know, either I'm going to make the decision to do that or I'm going to not do that, and then repeat. So as you keep doing that over and over, it's a pattern. Just like your bad behavior and your bad habit was learned, you can learn to do something else instead. So that's what I got for you guys. It was a really creative topic. Hopefully I delivered it well for you guys. But just want to recap. Like I said, you have your initial trigger. You have your bad behavior. And then you're going to have, you know, after that trigger, you're going to have, it causes a reward, right? It makes you feel a certain type of way. But instead of just reacting, you're going to notice that same urge. You're going to get curious and become aware. Then you're just going to, you know, feel the joy of letting go, which still makes you feel good because you had self-control. You didn't give in to that urge. And then you're going to repeat and it'll get stronger and stronger and easier to do. So that's a way that you guys can learn to break any bad habit. I just want to give you guys a little bit of tips for success, some prosperity points on this Sunday. And then I just want to tell you guys that's all I got. So thank you guys for coming, for watching, for sharing, for liking and commenting. And you know, I will see you guys on the next live video. And I want you guys to have a prosperous day and night on purpose. Take care. Bye.